Hello and welcome to this special presentation of Rajya Sabha TV from inside the Parliament House complex, the Question Hour. In the next half an hour, we'll bring to you some important questions asked by the members of Parliament and answered by the government from several ministries such as Law and Justice, Home Affairs and others as well. I'm Vishal Dahiya and with me is my colleague Kriti Mishra.
Thank you so much, Vishal. So let's begin the Question Hour show. And the first question that we've picked up is from member N. Gokulkrishnan, and this one pertains to the Ministry of Law and Justice. And the member has asked whether it is a fact that huge vacancies are cause of concern for government as well as higher judiciary, with more than 40 lakh cases pending in various high courts of India.
Well, the concerned ministry has given a detailed answer, and it says that as per the latest information available, 384 posts of judges were vacant in various high courts as on 1st of December 2018. As per the data available on the web portal of National Judicial Data Grid, 49.74 lakh cases are pending in high courts as on 17 December 2018, out of which 11.05 lakh cases are pending for more than 10 years, that is almost 22%. Now, the ministry further says that filling up of vacancies in the high courts is a continuous and collaborative process between the executive and the judiciary. While every effort is made to fill up the existing vacancies expeditiously, vacancies in High Court keep on arising on account of retirement, resignation or elevation of judges to the Supreme Court, and also due to increase in the strength of judges. Well, the next question is from two members of the Upper House, Ms. Ambika Soni and Dr. T. Subbirami Reddy, and they goes on to ask the Ministry of Railways whether it has constituted a committee to frame goods shed policy as per public-private partnership mode.
The government goes on to say that a committee has been constituted by Ministry of Railways on 24th of July 2018 to deliberate on the issue of upgradation and modernization of goods sheds on Indian Railways. Committee has to submit its report within 6 months from the date of its constitution. The committee is working on the modalities and is yet to submit a report. The next question has been asked by member Prabhakar Kore, and this one pertains to the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and he asks whether it is a fact that government has introduced several operational guidelines that eases insurance claim rules for early payment to farmers under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana.
Well, the Agriculture Ministry agrees and says that with a view to ensure better transparency, accountability and timely payment of claims to the farmers, the government has comprehensively revised the operational guidelines of the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, which has become effective from 1st of October. Specific cut-off dates, timelines for various activities, including timelines for releasing of premium subsidy to insurance companies by states, furnishing of yield data within 1 month of completion of harvest and payment of claims by insurance companies within 21 days of receipt of clear yield data from concerned state governments have been provided in the revised operational guidelines to ensure early settlement of claims to farmers. Now, revised operational guidelines also provide for target to incremental 10% coverage to insurance companies for coverage of known loony farmers. Well, just a short while back, my colleague Kriti Mishra spoke to the member Prabhakar Kore on his response to the answer given by the ministry on his question raised in the House. Let's listen.
Member of the Rajya Sabha, Mr. Prabhakar Kore, is joining us right now. Welcome to Rajya Sabha Television, sir. You've asked a very important question on the insurance claims to the farmers under Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, and the government has given a very elaborate answer. What is your take on the government's answer?
This is a revolutionary Yojana, the Prime Minister's dream. But it's not practically, it's not working in presently because it's a state government is involved. So many, first starting from farmers itself, because farmers, they don't know when they want to pay the premium because the most of the farmers are uneducated. So first starting from premium, the government has to plan for the properly. So that is the first thing. And second thing, whatever the insurance are, whatever farmers have made insurance, the claims are taking years together. That's because of the private insurance company, they come and survey. That is totally wrong. See, state government, they have a the statistic, for example, particular taluka, there is no rainfall. So there is no rainfall or any diseases has come, whole crop has spoiled. So they have statistic on that, they can pay immediately. And even premium, as per premium, the state government has to, full premium should be paid by the state government. It's a very small thing. It's thousands together, 1,000 crores together, we are exempting farmers' loan waiver. So the better, if you can do this, at least every year farmer can sure that he'll get something from his Fasal Bima, under the Fasal Bima Yojana.
So the government has also issued guidelines to the companies so that the farmers have easy access to the claims.
No, abhi to government jo kendra sarkar hai, ye jo workings ek saal se jo ho raha hai, jo defective hai, wo sab defective nikal ke naya scheme bana rahe. I think this scheme is going to be, I told you, is a revolution in agriculture, particularly farmers. Desh mein farmers ka aajkal aapko, every state have a problem of farmers ki kitne seesawed kar rahe hain, kyunki loan is a big problem, kyunki subsidized interest mein loan nahi mil rahe to, and he, uska crop to fail ho jata hai because of which is totally depend on nature. So the government of India has now, particularly Modi ji, has taken a personal interest to form the new scheme under this scheme. I think it will be easy and faster the claim should be paid to the farmers.
Right, sir. That was a very important question, and thank you so much for talking to Rajya Sabha Television.
So, well, that was the member Prabhakar Kore on the government's response. Let's now move on to the next question, and this is to the Ministry of Railways, and from three members of the House, namely Sukram Singh Yadav, Vishambar Prasad Nishad and Chaya Verma. They goes on to ask the ministry whether it is a fact that on several railway routes, trains are running more than the capacity of the railway tracks, due to which adequate time is not given for repairing the tracks, resulting in accidents.
There's a very important answer given by the government, and the government goes on to say that out of 265 sections on high density network routes, 185 sections are saturated. Though the overutilization is impacting the availability of time for maintenance, it does not affect inspections of tracks. If due to any reason the condition of track does not permit safe train operation at maximum permissible speed, speed restrictions are imposed as safety of the passengers is of utmost importance. The non-availability of blocks have been found to be primary cause of train derailment or accidents. There are 7 identified trunk routes across the country which are also termed as high density network routes, which are Delhi-Havra, Havra-Mumbai, Mumbai-Delhi, Delhi-Guwahati, Delhi-Chennai, Chennai-Havra and Chennai-Mumbai. Moving on to the next question, and this one is to the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, and the question has been asked by member Ajay Pratap Singh, and he goes on to ask whether government is considering to provide additional funds in MP lads for Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana.
Well, the government has given a detailed answer, and it says that the MP lads scheme provides for convergence with individual and standalone projects of other central and state government schemes in accordance with the scheme guidelines if such works of center or state government schemes are eligible under the MP lads. Now, there is no separate provision for allocation of funds for Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana under the MP lads. However, projects under the MP lads scheme can be implemented in the adopted villages under Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana if they are recommended by the concerned Honorable Member of Parliament. The next question is to the Ministry of Law and Justice, and this is from the member, Dr. Vikas Mahatme. He goes on to ask the ministry whether there is any proposal by the government to allow PIOs along with NRIs to vote in the elections.
Provisions already exist under Section 20A of the Representation of the People Act 1950 and the Conduct of Election Rules 1961, which enable overseas electors to cast their vote in person in the constituency where their names are registered. However, a bill to amend the Representation of the People Act 1951, enabling the overseas electors to cast their votes either in person or by proxy, has been passed by the Lok Sabha and is pending for consideration and passage in the Rajya Sabha. The next question pertains to food processing industries, and this one has been asked by member Muhammad Ali Khan, and he asks whether it is a fact that government is planning to set up an institution to fund food processing industries.
Well, the concerned ministry says in its answer that in pursuance to the budget announcement for financial year 2018-19, the ministry has drafted a new central sector scheme to promote establishment of specialized agro-processing financial institutions as a non-banking finance company, that is NBFC, with 20% equity of Government of India, subject to a maximum of 400 crore rupees. Now, the approval process for the same is underway. The ministry also says that the food processing industry sector in the country has received $6.64 billion worth of foreign direct investment equity inflow during the period 2013-14 to 2017-18. So, well, Kriti, this was it for our viewers as far as this part of the question hour is concerned.
Prashn Kal with our colleagues Arvind Singh and Akhilesh Suman on the other side. Stay tuned to Rajya Sabha Television.